Welcome to the build of my very first truck, start to finish.
We're going to get a truck for that kid.
So it's an 83 Chevy, one ton dually, but it's not going to be that very long. What do you think of it, Lan?
It's pretty cool.
See if Lan can load it on a trailer. Just go. There you go, stop.
We're gonna get it going. It's gonna be a four-wheel drive short bed, hopefully, when we're done. We'll see.
You're gonna have to steer, Landon.
Okay.
It's not what we came for.
What are we putting it in?
This is it.
It does have air conditioning. We'll keep that.
It does work.
We're gonna put a small block in it. This is two-wheel drive. We're gonna four-wheel drive it.
What did you get today, Land?
That.
Learner's permit.
He's about legal,
so we gotta get his truck done.
Today's the day Lando's been waiting for a bit. What's going down?
My truck is finally coming in the shop.
So Land's been tearing his Suburban apart for a while, getting the frame all stripped down, and we'll fire the forklift up, get it over here, cut all the good stuff we need off of it. Okay, so basically, we're taking the rear end out of this. We need the rear end.
Front end.
Then we need the front end, and then we got to take this, the motor mount stuff out of it. We got to have this cross member right here.
Luckily, we don't have to cut anything.
Because his is two-wheel drive. It's got, you'll see what it has in it.
Now, we just got to get that out of here.
We got everything off of this that we need. This is front end for his truck. He's going to get it tore apart and cleaned up, and then we're going to put the new knuckles on it and get it ready to go in his truck. Hopefully by the end of today, we got the front and the rear ends done. Front end's built. We got it all put together. We're ready to move on to the rear end now. It's in the shop. We're gonna get the rear end all unbolted today. Get that one that's sitting on the bed put in it. New leaves put in it. We're gonna get after it. Rear end's coming out. We're cutting this off because these leaf springs are shorter. So we gotta move this up to here. Then we'll cut the frame off, we'll trim the bed to fit. We got a lot of work to do to this thing, huh? That is the gist of what she's gonna look like. That's roughly how high it's gonna set.
We are currently, we already took the seat out to get it reupholstered.
Yep, that's going to get reupholstered.
And now I'm in the process of tearing the carpet out.
We just gotta take it out because we're putting four-wheel drive in it. So you're taking carpet out, and this whole piece right here will unbolt, and we'll take the one out of that other truck,
brown one out there.
Put in it, and it already has a four-wheel drive hole, everything in it. She's riding like a stink bug. Rear suspension's all done. Front's not done, so we'll get to that.
Got to get his driver's ed hours in.
Yeah.
And he's going with Uncle Joseph.
Oh yeah.
Who happens to be the driver's ed teacher.
Can't crash. We're gonna learn how to parallel park, three-point turns, U-turns. He can't speed.
He's just growing up.
All right, what we do here?
Radiator hoses, which is kicking my butt.
Don't have that. We got front bumper off. Front clip's getting close. He gets radiator hoses off. We gotta take some AC lines off. Just some miscellaneous stuff, and then we'll pull the hood. Front clips off, pull a motor, transmission, and then we're building.
Go down.
All right, front clip is off. We'll get this motor out of here now.
Motor is out of this pig.
Now he's got a full front end out of this thing. Get after it, Bubba.
Yeah.
So this is kind of what it's gonna look like. That's kind of ride height on it right there. We just gotta put all the mounts that we took off of that old Suburban on it now.
Got it.
Brake line.
What up?
Tight.
That sounds exciting.
Yes.
Brake line.
Pretty exciting stuff going on down here right now.
Yeah, we're gonna have to build a brake line that comes back to here somewhere. That's what we're doing now, is building those. Ow. Truck's setting on all fours right now. It's holding itself up. We got all the brake lines done. Everything is done. We're gonna tackle the steering and the motor mounts next. All right, so I just barely got all the steering built on this thing. This is the fun part of the build when we're going back together and the cool stuff's going on. Okay, let's see it, turn it. Steer it all the way. We got steering, everything's good. We're gonna tear this big block apart, see if we can't get some go fast parts put in it. So there we go. She's gutted.
Lifters are all in.
Cam's in it. I gotta pull this gear off of it. And then I can put, this is my new one up here, but I gotta put the bottom one on. It's a double roller timing, way better. I'm gonna run a little stiffer spring in this thing, so it needs a little better stuff. We're winning this battle. We're trying to do everything we can do to get this truck as ready as it can be when we get push rods, so that day we can put the motor together, throw it in, go do burnouts. I can do burnouts and land his truck, smoke his tires right off this thing. Anyhow, we're gonna get after this.
Calculations say
28 inches. Right there. Right there. We're cutting the frame off right behind here. Then we'll weld the bumper straight to the back of the frame once we get that done. Landon's new rear bumper. It's getting repurposed. This was off an old rock crawler. Now it's gonna be on Landon's truck. Landon won't be able to tear this one off of there. I got like 20 years experience derbying, keeping bumpers on. This one's staying on. Headache rack, gonzoed. All right, I got sides all cut. Now I gotta cut the little C channels underneath. I gotta cut those, and then we gotta start cutting that new C channel up and make a square box out of it, get it put together. It's his bed. He gets to do all the welding. Have at her, weld away, buddy. All right, this kid just got done welding this deck down. There's some that are better than others, but you know what? They ain't so bad. Yeah, it's good.
Right there like that, where we're at.
We left the rear bumper out so we'd have a step on it. That's the gist of it. Just got those runners put in. Now I'm gonna cut that piece that goes across it. It's in. We're gonna weld it up. She's coming together. Michelle's picking up tail lights for it today, and it'll look good.
One light hole.
Two light holes.
I got your crap.
Good deal. There's that one. All right, there's that. So we're just waiting on parts that haven't got here yet, except for drive lines. We can do drive lines. So we need 29 1/2 inch from right there to right there. That's our new running length is right there. So we gotta cut a little of that out. It's not a big deal when you got yourself a lathe. All right, so we got this thing within like 9 thousandths. Front drive line, plenty close enough. We're gonna go ahead and weld it, and we'll heat pull it back a little closer and call it good. We just got it assembled, put back together.
Ready to go.
Drive lines are built and in. Turned out pretty fair. Front one's all in. Steep angle, but it all turns. So everything looks good under here. That just happened. I'm gonna throw this thing together tonight. I'm ready. Okay. She's torqued.
She is all rockered.
Motor is together. It's right there. We thought it was gonna be easy. Ha ha! Winner. Just like so. That wasn't nearly as bad as I expected it to be. I thought it was gonna suck way worse than that. Now we're winning. Just like so. Front bumper's on. Exhaust is exhausted. Getting everything plumbed how we need it, and then we're gonna have to build us a heat shield to keep all this stuff from getting hot. So we still got a little wiring to do. Stay tuned, it'll run. what the crap's going on, but the rockers are just loose, like floppy loose.
We'll figure it out.
What's going on?
Get my license.
Woohoo! 2, 1.
We've determined that we've got bad lifters. They pump up and they start letting the valves leak and it's stupid. I adjusted them right the first time. It wasn't me that screwed up like I thought it was. But right now, I'm gonna put the interior back together. I'm gonna get this all done. Get it put together, his wiring all tucked up, and we'll be finished with this thing for a while until we get some lifters. Interior, done. Carpet's all in. Turned out pretty fair. It's looking good. We got good stuff this time. And I'm halfway nervous about pulling it out because I think the cam's junk too. We're hoping that those little bad boys right there solve all of our problems. It's the craziest thing I've ever dealt with. I've never had a motor do this to me, ever.
I don't know why I'm doing that.
What's up, Land?
We just barely found out that the cam is the problem.
So I'll show you. The lobes are chewed up. This is the first one I've ever had this with. I've had troubles before, but not this. I know the dilemma, I just don't know what caused it. The cam's in too far. There's something fishy with this whole scenario here. If you need something ruined, you just contact me. I can ruin anything you need ruined. What in the world? I have no idea why that was so tight. So we've ran into this here problem where the cam has been machined wrong. It was like a quarter of an inch too long. So when you'd put the timing chain on it, it would push it back in and it wouldn't line up anything. Never seen it before. Cam is in it. I don't know if you can see this or not, but the lifters are perfectly centered up in the bore now. It's like it should be. It's gonna be fine now. We're gonna put this thing together real quick, run through and adjust all of them, get it bolted back together and start it.
Crank it.
Sounds 1,000 times better.
Motor-wise, I think it's good. I'm just buttoning everything up right now, working on the taillights, trying to get them all done. We're doing a little wiring back here, get this all handled. Hopefully by the time Landon gets home from baseball practice, we can go for a ride.
Yeah!
Yes! Sounds like it's pretty healthy.
What are we about to do?
Take it on a first test drive, other than out of the shop and back in the shop.
Clutch. The drive decent?
Yeah. It's nice and smooth, don't jerk anywhere.
Must have done something right.
I love it.
That's taking over.
I want to see how it drives.
Brand new tires. Really?
Told y'all I was going to do it. I think we ought to go test the four-wheel drive out on this truck. Let's go do it. All right, Land, how do you like your truck?
I like it a lot.
Pretty good, huh?
It is.
So, have you had it in four-wheel drive yet?
No.
Well, today's the day. We're gonna go see if this thing works. We've never tested the four-wheel drive out, so here we go. We're just easing up this trail. It's a pretty good wash here that'll test it out a little. There you go, now you can drive through it. Didn't even hit the bumper in the back. What do you think, Land? Does she will?
Yeah, it does will.
We'll have to put a locker in it one of these days. Got her twisted up. She spun a little, but it's going to do what you want, isn't it?
Yeah, it should.
Okay, so this truck's handled. Gave us tons of grief, but in the end, we won. It's finished. And Lando's got himself a truck again. He'll be ripping it.
Thanks for watching.